I'm starting to think baby Sussex is already here. Announcement that Prince Harry will visit the Netherlands next week sets internet buzzing with rumors that he and Meghan may have become parents in secret. The news that the Duke of Sussex is said to visit the Netherlands next week has led to speculation that he and Meghan have already become parents in secret. Prince Harry will be in the country on May 8 and 9, despite the birth of his first child being imminent. Royal fans are now flocking to social media to share their belief that the royal baby has already been born. A royal aide previously said about Harry's trip abroad, he had always planned to go, but with the birth of his child due, it was not announced in advance in case he was no longer able to attend. He is pleased he is able to attend. While in the Netherlands, the Duke will undertake an official engagement in Amsterdam, Buckingham Palace has said. His Royal Highness will then travel to The Hague to officially launch the one-year countdown to the Invictus Games The Hague 2020. His wife Meghan is due any day now, and the trip could mean that Harry is either away for the birth or for the first few days of being a first-time father. The fevered online speculation comes after Chris Evans sensationally claimed live on air that the Duke and Duchess of Sussex have already had their baby. The 53-year-old Virgin Radio breakfast show presenter claimed, "I think I know something," as he suggested that there might be a new royal baby already. Evans said the Queen had been to see Prince Harry and Meghan, following reports that she joined them at home in Frogmore Cottage at Windsor Castle in Berkshire over the Easter weekend. Meghan told well-wishers her due date was the end of April or early May, but royal fans are still waiting for news, with no sign of the youngster so far. But Evans told his listeners on the show this morning, "We sit here still finding ourselves. Some say minus a new royal baby, or do we, ladies and gentlemen?" His news presenter Rachel Horn asked him, "What do you know?" And Evans then replied, "I'm not sure what I know, but I think I know something." Meghan and Harry have said they will only announce news of the birth once they have had time to celebrate together as a new family. On Sunday, Prince Harry, 34, was in attendance at the London Marathon, where he was able to congratulate men's winner Kenya's Eliud Kipchoge and women's winner Kenya's Bridget Kosgei. During his day spectating, Prince Harry also met with paramedics who were present at the marathon, in order to assist those in need of medical care on the day. Harry was at the marathon in his role as patron of the London Marathon Charitable Trust, and his appearance backed up claims that the couple are relaxed about Meghan, 37, entering labor. The prince managed to remain tight-lipped throughout the day, as the couple had agreed to keep the news private. On April 25, Harry had also attended Anzac Day services alongside sister-in-law Kate Middleton. His surprise appearance honored those citizens of Australia and New Zealand who died in military conflict or peacekeeping operations. Meghan's mother Doria Ragland is believed to have come to the UK in mid-April and has spent the past week with her daughter at Frogmore Cottage. However, the Duchess of Sussex has not been seen since she visited a boutique in London which offers a range of homeopathic treatments for new mothers and products that are blessed with healing chants. Meghan and Harry had spent 2 hours at the flagship Isle Apothecary store in Kensington in April. She was last pictured at a royal engagement with Harry on March 19, where she visited New Zealand House in London, in order to pay respects to the people who were massacred as they prayed at the New Zealand mosques. The couple were asked by the Queen to represent the British royal family at the event, having been the last members to visit the country when they went on their first overseas tour to the South Pacific in October last year. As the time ticks on, many royal fans are running out of patience for news and have been venting their frustration on social media while desperately appealing for information. It had previously been suggested that Prince Harry would take 2 weeks paternity leave following the birth of baby Sussex. However, this may no longer be the case, as his Amsterdam trip may now compromise this. He had been expected to take a break from official engagements in order to help his wife look after their baby, because it's a very modern dad thing to do. Harry's last paid job was as a captain in the army for 10 years, with his commission ending in 2015. Now the royal's duties are co-funded by the Queen and the Prince of Wales. A Buckingham Palace spokesman said, "I'm sure Her Majesty will accommodate a break from duties." On March 11, The couple also attended the annual Commonwealth Day service at Westminster Abbey, along with other members of the royal family. The couple don't seem to have hidden away from royal events, and it seemed Meghan had been attending engagements until the March. On March 11, the couple also visited Canada House, where she met with Canadian High Commissioner Janice Charette and watched a musical performance. Earlier in March, Meghan had also been part of a panel for International Women's Day, which had been organized by the Queen's Commonwealth Trust. The panel had discussed topics such as the various issues affecting modern women today. She attended the event without Prince Harry, but instead met with other activists such as singer Annie Lennox, former Australian Prime Minister Julia Gillard, and model Odwo Oboa. Meanwhile, events for the rest of 2019, which the couple have yet to confirm attendance for, is the Queen's Garden Party, which is usually hosted at Buckingham Palace in May.